And former world champion is never too far from the controversy.
I don't feel that I can be in the same room raising money for somebody after what he said on September the 11th. He can retract what he said, but he said it. It came out of his mouth, and in uncertain terms, what he said he meant on that occasion.
Fenwick's comments about Anthony Mundine come a day after he withdrew from a fundraiser for the Bali bombings, organised by close friend Dick Kane, because Mundine was also invited to attend. Fenwick and Mundine have had many run-ins over time, and this is one that the Marrickville Mauler isn't going to avoid, simply because he doesn't like him and feels he isn't alone.
Not just here in Australia, he's disliked everywhere. The Americans that are involved in the sport overseas, they dislike him. He just says stupid things. Instead of being humble and appreciating the opportunities we get in life, he is totally the opposite.
For now, Fenwick is focused on training another Australian champion, but the story of little-known Peter Manessis is inspirational. Manessis' weight ballooned to a massive 133 kilograms during an extended overseas travel to the Greek islands. He eventually woke up to his obesity when he tore his pants dancing in a Mykonos nightclub. The next day, he went shopping for a replacement pair, but none would fit him. He was so embarrassed, he vowed to get back to his fighting weight when he returned to Australia. His hard work has paid off. Manessis has lost a staggering 55 kilos in 7 months and has earned the right to challenge Jason Delisle for his Australian light heavyweight title, a fight Fenwick believes he'll win.
I'm very confident Peter Manessis has turned his life around, and he'll turn the Australian heavyweight title around on Friday night when he becomes victorious over Jason Delisle.
I'm just hungry, mate. I'm going to take the fight to him, and I want the belt, you know. I've done all the hard work in the gym. That's why I've lost the 55 kilos, and now it's time to show Jason Delisle that 55 kilos into him, sort of thing.
Yes, should be a very entertaining main event for the Australian light heavyweight title. All the talking is done, and now we're set for Peter Manessis and Jason Delisle, the champion, to get it on. Both men, of course, are under the 79.38 kilo limit for light heavyweights. 12 stone 6 in the old language, 175 pounds. Delisle doesn't enjoy a 7-centimetre edge in reach. 2 and a bit inches there. And just a little taller as well. But what a story this is. Peter Manessis in just 6 professional fights, and he's been in against some very tough opponents. And what gives the Fenwick camp so much confidence about Peter Manessis winning is that he fought Paul Smallman on October 25 and beat him over 6 rounds, had him down in the second, really did a good job against Smallman. And when you consider that Paul Smallman beat Jason Delisle 6 weeks prior to that, well, that form line, if you're a racing person, we are at Rose Hill Racecourse, that form line reads very well for Peter Manessis to cause an upset. On the flip side, of course, is the big edge in experience that Jason Delisle has, particularly if it goes beyond 6 rounds. Peter Manessis, regardless if he wins the title tonight or not, we take our hats off to him for a fantastic effort to get to this stage.
Yeah, you must take your hat off to Peter Manessis. He's trained hard. He's done a heck of a lot of work to get his weight down to 54, 55 kilos, what he's had to take off. The guys worked very, very hard, and I'm sure that, you know, they believe that they can win this fight. They wouldn't be here if they didn't. Look, I know styles make fights. Jason Delisle was beaten by Paul Smallman, and Peter Manessis beat Paul Smallman quite comfortably. But look, let me tell you, styles do make fights, so look, this is going to be a very, very interesting fight. Both boys have got good left hands. Look, Jason Delisle has good power as well, and so does Peter Manessis. So it's an intriguing fight. It's a fight that, look, don't blink, if anything could happen.
And Jason Delisle, well, what a champion he was to win the Australian belt against Peter Kariuki. Did it the tough way, was down in the 6th round on the end of a big right hand, climbed off the canvas to get the decision over 12 grueling rounds, perhaps the toughest 12-round fight that we've had on Fox Sports, certainly this year, maybe for some time. And now the decks have been cleared for the Australian light heavyweight title fight. Jason Delisle, Peter.